So my guys, today I'm going to touch the Fourier series of mathematics series 3 or engineering mathematics 3. So what comes in the Fourier series? First of all, to understand the Fourier series, there should be some terminology or some functions which we have the clear concept logic of that functions. So in Fourier series, first of all, we have to know about the periodic functions. So what is periodic functions? Periodic functions means that type of functions, my guys, that which repeats its interval in certain type of interval, or it repeats its value in certain time of interval in same value. That is called periodic functions. Like if t is the periodic functions, then my guys, f of x plus t is equal to f of x, or f of x plus t is equal to f of x plus 2t is equal to f of. It means t or 2t interval, it repeats the same value. That we called the periodic functions. So in periodic functions, we are taking an example. We can see fx is equal to x. So fx is equal to x, we are taking in minus pi to pi. It is the boundary range. It is the range minus pi to pi. So we are seeing that the graph of fx is equal to x between minus pi to pi is like this. Fx is equal to x, this, and fx is equal to minus x, this. So here we are seeing that after pi, it repeats same value. After minus pi, it repeats same value. Okay, my guys. So we can say that fx is equal to x is a periodic functions. And we can take or more example in which some competition exam also came in these questions, that example of periodic functions. So sin x, cos x, tan x, it is periodic functions, and its period is 2 pi. My guys, its period is 2 pi, means 2 pi interval, it repeats its same value. That we can take an example of sin x function. Okay, my guys, sin x. Yeah, this is the graph of sin x, y, x. So we are seeing that we can see n pi, pi, 2 pi. So we are seeing that after the pi or after pi, it repeats value, or after 2 pi, it repeats the same value, 2 pi, my guys. So we can say that 2 pi is the period of this function fx is equal to sin x. So my guys, now before reading the Fourier series, we should know the some basic terminology or basic idea about the functions, which is first periodic functions. We have the deep knowledge of periodic functions, and we know that it repeats its value after certain time of interval. After that, we have to know some more thing about the even and odd functions. So my guys, if fx is equal to even function, if even function comes, so what we are doing with the even functions? Oh my guys, if minus a to a, if the integration minus a to a, it is the definite integrations, because what is the meaning of definite integrations? It means the boundary condition are known, or lower limit and upper limit are known, we can say definite integrations. And if the lower limit and upper limit are not known, we can say indefinite integration. That's it. That is very easy, my guys. So minus a to a fx. So we are saying that twice of 0 to a fx dx, if function is even functions. Only we can say this if function is even functions, but if functions is odd functions, the value will be zero. My guys, we are very, this is very important result, and we should remember by heart. Okay, so we can say that the many questions arises in this topic, that how we are determined the function either is even or odd. So my guys, there is also some logic to identify whether it is even or odd. My guys, if f of minus x is equal to fx, then we can see that it is even functions. Like we can take example x square, cos x, it is even functions. But my guys, odd functions. So in case of odd functions, if f of minus x is equal to minus fx, then we can say it is odd functions. Example we can take, guys, f of x is equal to x cube. If you are putting minus x in minus x cube, minus, it is coming minus of fx, it means it is odd functions. Sin x, sin of minus x is equal to minus of sin x, so it is also odd functions. So my guys, now we are coming in by parts, because see my guys, before reading Fourier series, we should have some idea about the some certain type of terminology or certain type of functions. So it is just we are renewing the basic concept of by parts. If fx1 into fx2, so what we are doing, fx1 we are taking out of fx1 integrating fx2 minus of differentiating these functions fx1 into integrating fx2 into dx. We can see this and you can see this depth logic of this integration in my previous video. You can go and see there also. So my guys, now this is the chain rule concept. My guys, see, there is various tricks and logic to solving different type of functions of this definite integration or by parts. But today I am going to see learn to give you some logic about the different logic. Like see, x sin x, if we want to determine the value of x sin x, you can use my what I am going to give you the logic. Okay, my logic. Okay, see guys, x kept it as it is, integrate these functions, integration of sin x, integration of sin x minus cos x minus, my guys, differentiation of these functions, 1, and again integration of these functions, cos x minus sin x. So the value is minus x cos x plus sin x. How much easy you can see, guys, how much easy. The thing is that if you will do by parts, you will use islet property, you will do, you will let it first function, you will assume it second function, you will integrate it. It is very vast process. But in some competitive question examinations like GATE and IAS and some other competitive like RRB, SSE, JEE and some different type of competition examinations, we don't have that much time. Okay, so we have the consumption, we have very less amount of time. So in that less amount of time, we have to solve the questions with 100% accuracy, my guys. So that's why now I am coming in Fourier series, my guys. Before the previously whatever I teach you, that is the basic concepts of Fourier series, or before starting the Fourier series, that are the basic logic that we all have to be known. Okay, my guys. So Fourier series, my guys. So actually, what is Fourier series? See, if fx is a function defined and a period in the interval a to b, then the Fourier series is given by, my guys, fx is equal to a naught by 2 plus summation of n is equal to 1 to infinity an. You can learn also, my guys, an, with an there will be cos term, and with bn there will be sin term. So an cos 2n pi x by b minus a plus bn sin 2n pi x by bn b minus a. Okay, my guys. So what is a and b? A and b are the range of interval that are the main operant, like starting interval and ending interval, a and b. Okay, my guys. So what is a naught? A naught is equal to twice of b minus a integration of a to b fx dx. What is, my guys, an? An is equal to twice of b minus a integration of a to b fx with cos. We can see, guys, fx ke saath kya hoga? Only these functions, like in with fx with a naught, the value a naught is equal to twice of b minus a integration of a to b fx dx. But with an, what will happen with a naught? An, like with an, there will be an is equal to twice of b minus a integration of a to b fx cos of 2n 2n pi x by b minus a dx. Okay, my guys. So bn is also same, like you can see, guys, you can learn from here also. You can like you can use the trick cheat codes. An, there will be cos x with an, and there will be sin x with bn. So here also, what is an? Then an with, there will be cos x, bn there will be sin x. So we can remember that an is equal to twice of b minus a integration a to b fx cos of 2n pi x by b minus a into dx, and with bn, twice of b minus a integration of a to b fx sin of 2n pi x by b minus a dx. So my guys, we can take an example that many you can see many like examinations like mock out or some DLPP in Delhi exams. There are many engineering colleges exam. These questions are very famous questions, my guys. Like fx is equal to x square minus pi 2 pi, we can solve this in Fourier series function. Very easy. This is a, this is b. Do b minus a, there will be 2 pi. Split this value in terms of Fourier series. What will be there? Fx is equal to a naught by twice of integration n is equal to 1 to infinity an cos 2n pi x by 2i plus bn sin 2n pi x by 2 pi. After that, my guys, we have to know some value that I think everyone has known. And if anyone is getting problem in trigo, you can see my previous video that I have very soon I will be uploaded of trigonometry, and you can deeply see the how it comes. Sine n pi is equal to 0 and cos n pi is equal to minus 1 to the power n. So my guys, so the previously this is the Fourier series a naught by 2 summation of n is equal to 1 a n cos n nx plus b n sin nx. So my guys, what will be a naught? Now a naught, we will calculate the value of a naught, we will calculate the value of a n, we will calculate the value of b n, and we will put this value in this, and our answer is came a n s. So my guys, a naught is equal to 2 by 2 pi. How it came 2 by 2 pi? Twice of b minus a. So b minus a means pi minus of minus pi. So 2 pi. So twice of 2 pi minus pi 2 pi fx dx. So simple integration. The value came 2 pi square by 3. An also same like this 2 by 2 pi fx. You can see fx cos this. We will use some basic integrations. Basic integrations you can see. And the result came is 4 by n square minus 1 to the power n. Bn also same 2 by b minus a minus pi 2 pi. X square, this is x my guys. X square sin n pi. What is this? Twice of, see my guys, what is this? Twice of b minus a minus pi 2 pi fx sin 2n pi x by b minus a 2 pi. So fx is x. Okay my guys, so that is here. Fx is x square, so x square sin this pi. Simple, what we will have, what we have done, it is what, odd function. So odd functions, you know, we know minus pi to pi odd functions zero. So my guys, this is the concept previously I told before starting the Fourier series. So my guys, what we have done, we will put the value of a naught, a n and b n in this Fourier series. So fx is equal to 2 pi square by 3 is the value of, this is the value of a naught by 2 plus summation of n is equal to 1 to infinity. This is the value of a n, and you know the value of b n is 0. So this is the a n s. Okay my guys, so there is one more questions I came in front of you my guys. This is very famous and important questions, that the find the Fourier series of function fx is equal to x minus x square in interval minus pi to pi deducing these functions. Okay my guys, deducing. Okay, so this is very easy. Now I will tell you, and you will very easily you will do this. Okay, very easily. So Fourier series of fx is equal to x minus x square in minus pi to pi. So a naught by 2 summation of n is equal to 1 to infinity a n cos 2n pi x by 2 pi plus b n sin 2n pi x by 2 pi. So a naught by 2 summation of n is equal to 1 to infinity a n cos n nx plus b n sin nx, here as it is. Okay my guys, now what is the a naught? A naught is equal to minus pi 2 pi whole integration minus pi 2 pi fx dx. Okay, so what will be there? You can see here a naught minus 1 by pi minus pi 2 pi this. You will use basic integration, and the value comes is this. You can see this is very easy. Okay, very easy. You can see what had it done. This is x is odd functions, so odd functions is result is 0. This is even function, so even functions what come? Twice of 0 to pi, and do integration. This is we have done in 11th and 12th hour. Very easy. X square x cube by 3, put in value and you will get the result. Nothing else my guys. You can see Fourier series is one of the easiest and the easiest chapter in engineering mathematics. So don't worry about this chapter. Okay, so about an 1 by pi integration minus pi to pi x minus x square cos n pi. Simple, use integration formula and you will get the result minus 4 of minus 1 to the power n by x square. Bn is equal to minus pi to pi x minus x square sin nx, and you will get the, definitely you will get the result, this result you will get this result. Splitting all these terms, and one more thing, putting x is equal to 0 in this equations, x minus x square is equal to in this, we will derive this. So my guys, I'm not detailing you all the thing what I have done, because something you have also tried. So you try, and please you write in the comment box that sir, I am unable to understand these things. So I will give you the brief, I will give the screenshot, and I will put this into my page. Okay, so this is very just integration, wastage of time. Okay, that I will explain all this. Okay, so you can see putting x is equal to 0 and we will get these terms. Okay guys, so the thing is that now whatever we read in the Fourier series, that is for the continuous functions. But there is some Fourier series also that is for the discontinuous functions. So what is the logic behind in discontinuous functions, my guys? So in discontinuous functions, my guys, there will be some point where the function doesn't exist or the limit does not exist. It means, my guys, like you can see like this. So this is left hand limit, right hand limit. So these functions of left hand limit and value of right hand limit, limit of x tends to a plus doesn't equal to limit x tends to a minus 1. This is right hand limit, this is left hand limit. So my guys, like right hand limit is not equal to left hand limit, so we can say the function is discontinuous or function is not continuous in that point. Okay, so like you can see minus pi minus and x, the function is discontinuous at point x is equal to 0. So what we will do, nothing we will do, we will just solve this as it is, a naught by 2 summation of n is equal to 1, this, and we will put the value of x is equal to 0 and we will take out the value. That's it. And now, my guys, I will teach you a very important topic in the Fourier series, is half range Fourier cosine series and sine series. So what happened in the half range? Actually, guys, I want to tell you what is the meaning of half range cosine series and sine series. So my guys, I mean to say that half range cosine series, I will tell you first about the cosine series, after that I will tell you about the sine series. So in cosine series, my guys, see, you can see you will get a function fx and interval is 0 to pi. In the previously we get interval minus l to l and b minus a is equal to 2l. Okay, my guys, but now the interval is 0 to l and b minus a is equal to l. It means 2l, l is half, so l is get halved. That's why it is called half range cosine series and sine series. So there is a certain formula, we will put this value in formula and we will get the result. Fx is equal to a naught by 2 summation of n is equal to 1 to n is equal to 1 to infinity a n cos n pi x by l. This is the formula, my guys. A naught is equal to twice of l. Please, you get my guys, you get remembered this formula and you will put this formula in the given functions, you will get the result very easily. 2 by l 0 to l fx dx and a n is equal to 2 by l 0 to l fx cos n pi x by l dx. But in case of half range sine series, nothing, guys. See, in case of sine, there will be sine. In case of cos, there will be cos. Fx is equal to summation of n is equal to 1 to infinity. But my guys, you can see in sine series, there is no a naught by 2. You see there. There is not a naught by 2. There is directly n is equal to 1 to infinity, bn sine n pi x by l. And in bn, 2 by l, 0 to infinity, fx sine this. And you can guess, my guys, you can take an example also. There is very simple example. Just I will not waste the time, my guys, because the time is very less and exam is very soon. In the WBUT, there is 17th, there is a Fourier series chapter in the mathematics. So I will not take so much time, my guys. So half range sine and cosine series of fx is equal to x in interval 0 to pi. So what you will do? Summation half range sine series, what you will do in sine series? So fx is equal to, there is, you will use just formula, n is equal to 1 to infinity, bn sine nx. Bn is equal to 2 by pi, 0 to pi, fx sine nx. Just use the value and x and this, use my, like previously I told you to use this, my formula. See, my logic. See, my logic, x sine x. So you will use same, x sine x, my logic. First kept it outside, integrate this, minus of again, differentiate these functions and integrate this, you will get a result. Answer is this. Summation of n is equal to 1 to infinity, minus 2 by n, minus 1 to the power n, sine nx dx. So my guys, the new concept I came with to you, Euler's formula for Fourier series. See, the Fourier series, what we have read previously. Yeah, previously we read about the, I'm marking, number one, Fourier series for continuous functions, second, Fourier series for discontinuous functions, that's it. After that, Euler's formula for, after that, one more thing I have read, I have taught you, half range sine and cosine series Okay, after that there is Euler's formula. There is very simple in Euler's formula for Fourier series, my guys. See, the Fourier series for of a functions fx in the interval alpha to alpha plus 2 pi, it is given. And just this is the formula that we have to remember. Fx is equal to a naught by 2 summation of n is equal to 1 to infinity an cos n by nx plus bn sin nx. And a naught is equal to 1 by pi alpha to 2 alpha plus 2 pi fx dx. And n is equal to 1 by pi alpha to alpha plus 2 alpha fx cos nx. And 1 by pi alpha plus 2 alpha fx sin nx. So this is the Euler's formula for a naught, bn, an. And a naught, bn, an are also got Fourier constant. Okay, my guys, that's it. You will get a certain functions. Put the value of fx here, here, and here. You will get the result and integrate it. Just integration, my guys, nothing else. Just integration. So one more concept I came in front of you, my guys. Dirichlet's condition for Fourier series. So my guys, what is Dirichlet's condition? Nothing is there in Dirichlet's condition, my guys. You can see a function fx can be expanded in Fourier series where a naught plus n is equal to 1 to infinity an cos nx plus bn sin nx, where a naught, an, bn are the constant if period that. So these are the three conditions it should be fulfilled for the Dirichlet's condition. One is fx is period in single value function. Single value means in single point you will get single value, that is single valued functions, and it should be finite number, it should not be infinite, and of discontinuity. It should be the finite number of discontinuity. It means the discontinuous function should be finite in number, and fx is periodic. And the third condition for the Dirichlet's condition is fx has at most a finite number of maxima and minima. After that, my guys, the thing which I should teach you is complex form of Fourier series. So what comes under the complex form of Fourier series, my guys? See, Fourier series is in interval minus alpha to alpha. So fx is equal to a naught by 2, n is equal to 1, an cos n pi x by l plus bn sin n pi x by l, this is. And a naught, this value same, b an same, bn same. Now my guys, you can see the basic concept. See, I will teach you in the trigo, and very soonly I will upload the chapter of trigo on my channel. So cos x is equal to, this is the formula, you have to remember, e to the power ix plus e to the power minus ix by 2 sin x e to the power ix minus e to the power minus ix by 2y. So my guys, cos of n pi x by l is this value, sine of n pi x by l is this value. You will remember just what, nothing I have done, I have put this value in front of x. Okay, so my guys, this formula you have to remember, very important formula for complex Fourier series. See, fx is equal to n is equal to minus infinity to infinity cn e to the power inx, where cn is equal to 1 by 2 pi minus pi to pi fx e to the power inx. Nothing, there is function should be given, we put the value of function in this and value of cn in this, you will get the answer. That only this much thing you have to do in the complex Fourier series, nothing else. After that, the last topic of after completing the complex Fourier series, the last topic of the Fourier series is Percival identity for Fourier series. Percival identity. So what comes in the Percival identity? Nothing, my guys. It is also very easy. Just some modification is done. You can see here. The Fourier series, this is the given Fourier series in interval 0 to 2L. Fx is equal to, my guys, a naught by 2 plus n is equal to 1 to infinity an cos n pi x by L plus bn sin n pi x by L. So a naught is equal to 1 by L integration 0 to 2L fx dx, n is equal to 1 by L 0 to 2L fx cos n pi x by l dx, bn is equal to 1 by l 0 to 2L fx sin n pi x by l dx. So my guys, this is the basic concept you have read in the previously. This is just the Fourier series expansion. But what is the meaning, what partial actually Parseval is the scientist who have explained this thing. So what Parseval, first Parseval has think, he thought that Fourier series of fx is converging. This is important term converging. Parseval means converging, converging uniformity. So this is the most important formula, my guys, that you have to remember. 0 to 2L fx whole square dx is equal to L into a naught whole square by 2 plus summation of n is equal to 1 to infinity an square plus bn square. So my guys, there is proof of also this. You can see proof, nothing, just you multiply fx in this equation 1, multiply fx in this equation 1, this is the equation 1, my guys, you can see equation 1, multiply fx and integrate 0 to 2l, 0 to 2l fx whole square, this a naught by 2, 0 to 2l fx into dx plus n is equal to 1 to infinity an, 0 to 2l fx into cos n pi x, and this just multiply both side, multiplying fx and integrating 0 to 2l, we are getting value this, hence proved. So my guys, this is the last formula in the Parseval identity in interval minus L to L, is minus L to L fx whole square dx, L into a naught whole square by 2 plus summation of n is equal to 1 to infinity an square plus bn square. And one more formula, half range cosine series in terms of Parseval identity. Parseval identity is 0 to L fx whole square. You can see whole square dx L by 2 a naught whole square by 2 plus n is equal to 1 to infinity an square. So my guys, after last my in the next classes I will teach you the Fourier transform. So my guys, today I give you a brief, or on an averagely the brief information about the Fourier series. You all guys, you have to remember the, you have all have guys, you have to remember the formula whatever I teach to you. And the guys, please do more questions and practice more questions, and you will definitely get a good marks in your examinations or in your competitive exam. Just practice, just I help you in somehow to progress yourself, and you have to progress yourself. So my guys, thank you and have a nice day. Myself Anjan Kumar. So I will try to upload some video that you will definitely get helped in certain time or certain confusions. So thank you, my guys.